In this lesson, you will learn how to use procedural textures made in Substance Designer in vray for Cinema 4D. Hi, my name is Benjamin with BWMC. In this class, we use Substance Designer, Maxon's Cinema 4D, and Chaos Group's vray for Cinema 4D. Using procedural textures has a number of benefits. Every texture can be unique. You have full control over the look of the texture. You are not restricted by the resolution of a scanned or photographed texture. You will have all needed channels available for export, for all workflows. And you can convert Metalness Roughness workflow to Specular Glossiness workflow. Now let's compare the two textures. The left wall has a low resolution concrete texture. The image looks blurry. Also, making alterations can be time consuming. The right wall has a texture made with Substance Designer with a resolution of 4096 by 4096 pixels. The difference is astonishing even from this far away. Now imagine being closer to the wall. Using a pre-made Substance Designer material takes very little time and will produce great results. But before we get to it, I will have to talk about the PBR workflow. Please bear with me, I will keep it short. In real-time graphics like game engines, PBR is most often used. PBR stands for physically based rendering. That doesn't mean that other approaches are not physically based. PBR comes in different flavors. Most often, the metallic roughness workflow is used. There are essentially two materials that we have to consider: dielectric and conductive. The index of refraction values, IOR, don't apply to conductive materials the same way they apply to dielectric materials. It's a lot more complicated. That's why PBR has introduced a metalness node within the reflection channel. White is metal or conductive. Black or zero are non-metals or dielectric. In the specular glossiness workflow, which is the traditional way of setting up materials, we use IOR values even for conductive materials. We need to use very high values of up to 200 to fake a desired look. There's a lot more to know about it, but for the sake of this lesson, we will keep it simple. Why am I telling you this? In vray for Cinema 4D version 3.7, we don't have a metallic node. Even though we have PBR workflow in vray and we can turn on roughness, we can't use the metallic slot just yet because it is not implemented yet. That's why we will stick to the specular glossiness workflow. Thankfully, Substance Designer can convert materials from one workflow to another. But we have to set up the project a little differently. Open Substance Designer and click on Use Substance. Give your graph a name. Choose a size of 4096 by 4096 pixel. The graph template also has a PBR specular glossiness template, but we will use an empty template. Click OK. The first thing we are going to do is to change from our metalness roughness to specular glossiness workflow. In the 3D view, click on Materials, Default, Physically Specular Glossiness, Parallax Occlusion. We will use a concrete material from the library. On the lower left, choose PBR Materials, Concrete, and drag Concrete 44. Into the graph window. Right click on it and choose View in 3D View. Note how it doesn't look like concrete at all. What we see here is an indication that Concrete 44 is a metalness roughness material, which vray 3.7 doesn't understand fully. so we will convert it to something vray compatible. Thankfully, Substance Designer comes with a converter. In the library window, find material filters, PBR utilities, base color metallic roughness converter, and drag it into the graph window. Click on the converter to open the properties window. Go to instance parameters and choose target vray GGX. The converter will now have output nodes for the channel diffuse, normal map, reflection, glossiness, and 1 over IOR. Now drag the output nodes of the original concrete 44 material to the converter. Everything will connect automatically except for our normal map. We will take care of it in a moment. To see the converted material in our 3D view, right-click on the converter and choose View in 3D. Now things are looking great again. If you want, you can change some parameters of the concrete 44 material to make it unique. Click on the concrete 44 material to open its properties. Under instance parameters, advanced parameters, you'll find sliders for cracks, dirtiness, and various color settings. Once you're happy, we can prepare the export of our textures. In order to export our channels, we will have to create output nodes. Right-click on the converter and select Create Output Nodes. Substance Designer will ask you if you want to create output nodes for hidden connectors. Click No. Right-click on the canvas and select Compute Node Thumbnails to see what's going on. Everything looks fine except for our normal map. It's empty. So just delete this output node. Instead, right-click on our original concrete 44 material and choose Create Output Node. And once more say no to hidden connectors. Double-click on the normal output node to see it in the 2D view. Our normal information is there. Delete the ambient occlusion and height output nodes because we won't need them later. Now we are ready to export. In the toolbar of the graph window, click on the wrench and select Export Outputs. Choose a folder, format, and pattern, which is essentially the file name. Make sure you have the variable identifier in the name. Otherwise, Substance Designer will export all channels under the same name, which effectively will only export one channel. Make sure all output channels are checked and hit Export Outputs. Now let's go to our Cinema 4D scene file and set up our vray standard material with the newly created textures. The right wall will get the new material so we can compare the textures better. This step is pretty straightforward. We will create our new concrete material. Create a new vray standard material. Make sure you'll always use a vray advanced bitmap node and put your texture in there. Also, I like to set the blur level to something lower than 1. I prefer to set it to 0.2, at least for the diffused channel texture. So under Basic, we put our diffuse texture into a vray advanced bitmap node and set blur to 0.2. On On a reflection, we put the reflection texture, and on the glossiness, we put the glossiness texture. Usually, IOR for reflection is the same as IOR for refraction. In the vray standard material, the value of IOR for reflection comes from the IOR for refraction channel. So let's go to the refraction channel and add the IOR map into the IOR texture slot. In the bump channel, choose map type normal map in tangent space and put in your normal map within a vray advanced bitmap node. I like my interior concrete rather polished, so I choose a low normal strength amount of 0.2. Apply our new material to the right wall and hit render. Now you can admire your newly created texture that is higher in resolution with a unique style. And if you want to adjust it, you can just quickly go back to Substance Designer and tweak the settings for cracks, dirt, and color and re-export the textures. If you think this lesson was valuable to you, please like this video and subscribe to our channel. Make sure you hit the bell icon to get notifications every time we publish a new video. Thank you for watching.